Good morning, Patriots. Welcome to Rex Pines TV. My name is Payne Forbes. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
And now for our school mission statement.
We the Patriots achieve greatness through high expectations, passion, and perseverance.
Thank you. You may now be seated. Today is Monday, February 8th, 2021. Let's go to Randy for our Black History Spotlight.
Thank you, Peyton. Today we spotlight John Mercer Langston, who was the first Black man to become a lawyer when he passed the bar in Ohio, 1854. When he was elected town clerk for Brown Helm, Ohio in 1855, Langston became one of the first African Americans ever elected to the public office in America. John Mercer Langston was also the great uncle of Langston Hughes, famed poet of the Harlem Renaissance. Langston was always wanted to become a lawyer, but this was a profession so difficult to achieve, especially for a Black man in the 1800s. Only three Black men in the nation had officially held this title in 1855. Never, never give up your dreams. Now let's go to Scott for the sports highlights.
Thank you, Randy. Today's sports highlights are brought to you by the Patriots. Ice hockey is a fast, fluid, and exciting team sport. This is a game between two teams, each usually having six players who wear skates and compete on an ice rink. The object is to propel a vulcanized rubber disc, the puck, past the goal line and into a net guarded by a goaltender or goalie. It draws big crowds at the Olympic Games thanks to the drama and tension of the matches. It is a favorite Canadian pastime, which makes sense given that Canada has only 3 or 4 months of warm weather per year. Now let's go to Noah for the lunch report.
Thank you, Scott. Today's lunch is cheese panini, baked beans, applesauce, and milk. Bon appetit! Now let's go to Sonia for our National League segment.
Thank you, Noah. Good morning, Patriots. This week is National Jello Week. Yep, this week is dedicated to this wonderful diggly treat. Jello is mostly made of gelatin with an addition of fruit syrup. Though straight gelatin doesn't taste as great, it's what gives gelatin that nice gelatinous or jiggly feeling. So go out and grab your favorite flavor or color of Jello. And dig in. Happy National Jello Week. Let's get back to Peyton.
Thanks, Sonia. Scholars, you are doing an amazing job on this month's iReady Challenge. Let's keep working towards our goal of 30 lessons with February's iReady Reading Challenge. Pass 30 Reading iReady lessons between February 1st and February 26th to be part of a spectacular sub-party. Start today to get all 30 lessons in. Patriots, we continue celebrating Black history. Today we should take a virtual field trip with our teacher or ourselves to the National Museum of African American History and Culture. Tomorrow, you get to let your artistic side shine as we draw a color of picture Hank Aaron or Kobe Bryant. Be sure to tune in every day to find out what fun activity or dress down will be going on during the rest of February. I can't wait to see your beautiful artwork. Now let's see what the weather's going to be like today with David.
Thank you, Peyton. Today's weather in Pembroke Pines, Florida is forecast to be 82 degrees Fahrenheit and thunderstorms. Looks like we might need to get those raincoats back out. Now let's go to Samuel for the joke of the day.
Thank you, David. And here's today's joke of the day. Why did the pitcher go to jail? Because he got framed. Now let's go back to Peyton.
Thank you, Samuel. That was too funny. And now let's check in with Solomon for today's birthdays.
Thanks, Peyton. Today's birthday boys and girls are Jenna, Pierre Lewis, Julian Gomez, Stephanie Quant, Caleb Benjamin, Sophia Furman, Kimberly Gallen, and Luana Rootnerain. Happy birthday. Now let's go back to Peyton.
Thank you, Solomon. Patriots, don't forget your Pat's expectations. It represents present yourself positively, act kindly towards others, treat the school's environment respectfully, and succeed at everything. Congrats to Ms. Milholm, Ms. Antori, Ms. Julian, Ms. Samuel, Ms. Stone, Ms. Dry, Ms. Mraz, Ms. Newton, Ms. Jimenez, Ms. Calabrese, Ms. Hendrickson, Ms. Escher, Ms. Imdenkwa, Ms. Santi Stabon, Ms. Torres, and Ms. Barrow. You had the correct answer to Friday's riddle, which was, this ancient invention allows people to see through walls. What is it? The correct answer to this riddle was a window. Now for today's riddle. A window cleaner is cleaning a window on the 25th floor of a skyscraper when suddenly he slips and falls. He has no safety equipment and nothing to soften his fall, and yet he is not hurt. How can this be? A window cleaner is cleaning a window on the 25th floor of a skyscraper when he suddenly slips and falls. He has no safety equipment and nothing to soften his fall, and yet he is not hurt. How can this be? Teachers, please send your answers to pines.renaissance@gmail.com before 10 a.m. in order for your response to be reviewed. Winners will be announced the following day. Everyone at RPTV would like to wish you all a marvelous Monday. And don't forget, remember, we unite, rise. Have a great day.